Welcome back to Be Like Buddy Central. Today we're going to walk through Be Like Buddy Episode 1, Eating at the Table. And we're going to stop at each point where we considered the experience of a child with autism, sensory integration dysfunction perhaps, trouble with transitions, and so you can see how we put the show together from those respects. So we're just going to kick right on into it and stop along the way. Okay, so already we're going to stop. The episode's only 2 seconds old. We had a choice to make as to how to introduce the show. Musically, we elected for a bass line to come in. That's opposed to a fanfare or guitars or, you know, rock music or like you see in a lot of children's shows these days. We said from a sensory perspective, a slow fade in from black and a bass line might be the way to introduce this show in a less kind of hostile way for children with sensory integration dysfunction and trouble with transitions. Let's keep going.
Buddy, it's time to start!
Okay, going to stop right there because there's a couple of things that we considered when building this part of the show. First, you've just seen a little bit of applied behavioral analysis being used. The singer said, hey, buddy, it's time to start. Be like Buddy then, Buddy then appeared from behind the logo, which was the appropriate thing to do, and then he was rewarded by the children's choir celebrating his actions. Another thing that's going on is that we have Be Like Buddy is a short verbal prompt, and we've chosen the name Buddy as opposed to any other because children with autism tend to be boys, or at least 5 times as often as girls. So what we find is these young boys working with their therapists and their clinicians and developing, you know, caring relationships so that they get the nickname. And one that we've commonly heard is Buddy. So every time in the show that Buddy gets direction or gets praise or gets reinforcement, by extension, we hope any child who has that nickname hears it being said almost directly to them. Additionally, in the design of the logo itself, although it's bright and colorful and cheerful, it's also incredibly low contrast. So if there are children in the audience who have sensory integration dysfunction that are particularly prone to kind of visual noise, you'll notice that only Buddy's eyes and the word Buddy and those 2 stars really stand out. The whole yellow to orange gradation and the words be like, they kind of fall away. So not that we expect that people experience it with this grayscale, but there aren't these hard-edged patterns going on. So we thought about that a little bit.
Today's the day I'm gonna be like Buddy, 'cause I know there's nothing I can't do. Today's the day.
Okay, I'm going to stop right there just for a brief second to say that the spinning of the star that you're going to see in the background and of the little star that's there, you know, we've just observed that there are some children in the audience who like spinning things, whether it be fans or spinning something in their hands for all different reasons. So we had our choice of big full-screen animations and crazy things happening. We decided to keep it local to the center of the screen, and by using stars, which children on the spectrum might be used to seeing with their visual schedules that they have in use at their school or in their home, and to use spinning as a major motif in the animations.
I'm gonna be like Buddy, 'cause today I'm gonna try something new.
Huh? Eating at the table. Yay!
So we're modeling a behavior right here that we want the child with autism, the one in the audience, to look forward to a new activity.
Buddy, it's time for dinner.
Okay, so this therapist has begun a short sentence with his name, which I have seen personally in my life, and I've witnessed other therapists and clinicians use it, this style of talking where you get the attention of the child by saying the name first and then delivering the message succinctly so that you don't say, it's time for dinner, buddy, where the child doesn't know that you're talking to him or her when you said that whole sentence, and the child would have to then reconstruct it or hear it again. So,
Hyper Monkey, don't you hear your stomach growling?
So again, we want to get that mind-body connection. Like when I hear this rumbling in my stomach, that means I should eat. And that's not something that's intuitive, strangely, to some children that we've seen.
You can watch Hyper Monkey later. This is what we're going to do now.
So something just happened there. Buddy is doing a preferred activity, and some children have trouble transitioning from a preferred activity to a non-preferred activity, and don't we all? So what she is doing is reassuring Buddy that Be Like Buddy isn't going anywhere. They can stop it right there. They can return to it later. That this isn't the end of Be Like Buddy forever. It's something that they can return to. And in fact, you see on the schedule that she has already handwritten in that once he completes this activity, he's going to come right back to it.
First, you'll sit on a chair at the table. Huh? Then, you'll put food in your mouth with a fork or a spoon, not your hands. You'll stay and eat all of the food on your dish. And when you're all done, ask, may I be excused?
So she's walking him through what they're going to do using a visual schedule. So there are pictures to look at that, and very simple, iconic kind of pictures. And then the words. And you'll see in autism, in life, we all proceed from very simple schedules to handheld schedules in our PDA or a calendar and reminder system. But right now we're going to start with very basic pictures and very simple sentences that are very specific.
If you want more to eat or drink, you can ask please. And if you need to wipe your hands or your mouth, use a napkin. I know it can be hard to sit quietly for a while, but if you eat your dinner and earn all your stars, you can watch
Hyper Monkey!
So we're going to stop right here and just point out the fact that she is pointing out things that might happen along the way. And it's important to point out difficulties because they're going to happen and unexpected things will happen. So she's giving him contingencies. If you need more, here's how to handle it, so that if the child gets to a place where he or she wants more, they're not in a crisis as to how to handle it, that they're not sure. So if you need to wipe your hands or your face, if you want to ask more, and you know what? You're going to have to sit at the table for a little while, and I know that that's difficult for you to do. So she's telegraphing the fact that those difficulties are actually part of the process that can be handled.
Let's go. Woo-hoo. Ah-ha! The table! Great job, buddy. You've already earned your first star.
So I'll stop it right there and say that the immediacy with which she praises his coming to the table is very important. It's not useful to have a time delay between the activity and the reward for it. It's not useful to come back to it later and say, when you came to the table right away, that was really great. You want to keep that child in the moment within that activity and reinforce it.
Sit on a chair at the table. Great job. Up, buddy. You have to earn a few more stars before you get up. Next, you have to
eat.
Well, let's check your schedule. Put food in your mouth with a fork or a spoon.
So again, a very specific line there. Put food in your mouth with a fork or a spoon, because the word eat can be overused and can mean very different things. It could mean, it could just eat dinner means eating the whole thing. Or I want you to eat. It's time to go eat. It is usually reserved for the whole meal. You want to be very specific about what you want the child to do. And so we could have used take a bite, keep taking bites until it's all gone. But we also wanted to get the use of the utensils in there. Another thing that you're looking at right now is the range of foods that we've supplied. There's a crunchy food, there is a rubbery, chewy food in the beans, and then there's a soft food in the potatoes. And sometimes it is not the taste of the food, but the texture of the food that's a real barrier. Ideally, we would have had a wet food here, like a peach or a pear or something like that, but we have a felt puppet.
Good choice, buddy. You've earned another star. Put food in your mouth with a fork or a spoon. Now keep going until you've finished all the food on your plate, and you'll earn your next star. Buddy, if you want more, you say, may I have some juice, please?
Juice, please.
Good enough.
And again, in that little interaction, the child might not be able to say the whole request. It might be able to mentally image the whole request in his or her mind, but not be able, because of dyspraxia of speech or apraxia of speech or some other challenge, might not be able to get the whole request out there. So she's saying he didn't just hold up his cup and say and leave it out there. He actually made the attempt to say more, please, and that was enough that he would be successful in life if he did that.
And here's your juice, buddy. You're doing great, buddy. 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 That's why we have a napkin. To wipe our face and hands. Good job. You're doing it all by yourself.
All done.
Wow. You must have been really hungry.
Again, she's bringing back in his actions to his body. So she's saying, you must have been hungry. That's why you ate so much. So it's a little bit of a time delay, but she did it up front too with the your stomach's growling. That means it's time to go eat. So the next time you experience that, go and eat or prompt for some eating. Here again, she's tying in that mind-body connection.
And by finishing everything on your plate, you've earned another star. Stay and eat all of the food on your dish.
Hyper monkey?
Well, let's see. You've earned 3 stars out of 4. There's only 1 more left. When you're all done and you want to get up, you say, May
I be excused?
Absolutely.
There's something I want to point out here that I didn't point out throughout the rest of the show, because we're now listening to the sound effects for Hyper Monkey, the show that Buddy was working for, is that in thinking back or replaying the video, you're not going to hear a lot of room tone. Of course, there's stuff going on in the house, and there's wind noise, and there's traffic noise outside. We've dialed all of that back down for the primarily visual learner who, in the audience, who might have sensory integration dysfunction and can only really... Or who benefits from having one piece of stimulus at a time. So there's usually something going on visually or something being said, occasionally an overlap between the two, but there's no music throughout the show. The live sound is kind of dialed down a little bit, except when we need to reintroduce it.
Buddy, I am so glad that you ate at the table. You were very nice, and now you know what to expect. Sit on a chair at the table. Put food in your mouth with a fork or a spoon. Stay and eat all of the food on your dish. Ask, may I be excused? Ask, please, when you want more. Wipe with a napkin, not your sleeve.
Ooh, is this the one where Hyper Monkey goes? Great job, buddy. You did it.
So I'll stop there without taking you through the full credits, but a couple of great things happened right there. First, the mom in this episode took Buddy out of his world, took him from what he was doing. He was invested in his favorite program and said, for my sake, come into my world, eat the way I eat, be at the table, follow these instructions, which are not necessarily intuitive. And he did that, you know, graciously, and he followed the schedule, and he did it completely. I think as a social reward at the end, the mother goes back into his world to validate that what he's doing isn't bad or wrong. The mother goes in and says, Buddy, what you're doing is great too. And she fully does that by putting on the monkey ears, by holding the stuffed monkey, by having popcorn, sitting on the couch, and doing what it is that Buddy enjoys doing. The final thing I'll say is that we have a child beginning the end credit music by saying, great job, Buddy, you did it. And the remainder of the end credit music is children congratulating Buddy.